There is officially only one thing cooler than giant robots.
Microscopic robots! Hey there, Decepticons. Trace and Julian here for DNews. Medicine and robots go together like ice cream and robots.
Yeah, everything is better with robots.
It's true. But some robots, they're better than others. When it comes to the robots, we mostly talk about Atlas or Big Dog, but you maybe should be thinking smaller, like the size of a red blood cell.
Right. Why not have tiny robots that you could ingest? Now, it's not easy to achieve robots on the nanometer scale just by miniaturizing the systems we already have, known as the top-down approach. You know what they say? Nanobot ain't easy.
I do say that.
The other method, which might be better, is to build machines from the bottom up, atom by atom, small enough to swim through the bloodstream to monitor our health, deliver drugs, and perform surgeries as needed. Obviously, we aren't there yet, but we are making progress.
That's right. Scientists have made machines that you can eat. In early 2015, scientists from MIT devised an origami robot, which is exactly what it sounds like. It's a robot that can fold itself into a shape that lets it propel itself.
Sure, it's much bigger than nanoscopic or even microscopic, but because it's foldable, it can be accordioned down to a size that fits in a pill. The scientists who made it think it might be useful for removing button batteries in the stomach that were accidentally swallowed, and look awfully cute doing it, though that's just my opinion. It can't control its own movements yet, though. It needs an operator applying a magnetic field to swim.
Do people swallow that many button batteries? Not to be outdone, scientists from UC San Diego tested tiny bots just 20 micrometers in length that could actually propel themselves through stomach acid. When fed to a mouse, these machines shot off toward the stomach's walls and embedded themselves in the lining where they delivered a drug. It was the first instance of a nanobot being used on a living animal.
Another group of researchers from ETH Zurich also came up with the idea of using external magnets to solve the problem of locomotion, like the folks at MIT. They've invented robots so small, 3 billion of them could fit in a teaspoon.
You actually won't swallow these bots, though. Their creators imagine that they'll be more useful if they're injected into your eye, where they would swim through the vitreous humor and poke the blood vessels to break up blood clots.
But the goal is to get even smaller, totally autonomous machines. To quote the late Nobel Prize-winning physicist Richard Fineman, it would be interesting in surgery if you could swallow the surgeon. That's my Richard Fineman impression.
It's just like a hint of walking. Wow! Fineman proposed that in 1959 and is generally credited with kickstarting this nanotechnology movement. He laid out 2 challenges to the scientific community: shrink the information on the page of a book down 25,000 times, and create a motor that was just 1/64th of a cubic inch. The reward for completing either of those challenges was a princely $1,000.
Within a year, someone claimed the prize for challenge number 2. Bill McClellan used watchmaking techniques, toothpicks, and the patience of a saint to build a tiny conventional electric motor. That was over 50 years ago, so why isn't my body filled with nanobots that keep me healthy and immortal? Probably because Fineman, genius though he was, didn't make the size requirement small enough. The motor is about the size of a grain of salt, which is absolutely huge compared to something like a red blood cell.
Fineman's dream is alive and well, and in fact, even though his original challenges were met, the Foresight Institute has offered a $250,000 prize, named the Fineman Grand Prize, to anyone who can build a nanoscale robotic arm and computer.
Since this nano future is being built at universities, maybe the person to claim that new prize will be you. But could robots ever evolve on their own? Could they even one day be indistinguishable from us? Seeker Stories took a look at that and met a robot named Bina 48. Check it out here.
Bina 48 is one of the most advanced social robots in the world. Equipped with artificial intelligence software called a character engine, social robots can think, engage, and maybe evolve.
So, would you swallow a robot? No, stop it. Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and we'll see you next time on DNews.